Johnson & Johnson vaccine, will you need a booster too? Most COVID-19 vaccines are given in two doses. One vaccine given in a single dose is from Johnson & Johnson. Now with boosters in discussions, what will happen to those who got this vaccine? Will you get a booster too? Well, there's a plan, but a company must give regulators new data before anything can be decided. But before we go on, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. According to Fox News, almost 14 million people received the J&J vaccine in the US alone. While boosters for Pfizer and Moderna vaccines are certain, the one for J&J is still unclear. Recently, the US CDC showed the waning effectiveness of mRNA vaccines. From March to May 2021, the vaccines had a performance of 74.7% before Delta established itself. During June to July, the effectiveness crashed to 53.1%, a big drop when Delta scattered in many cities. If you have the J&J vaccine, you probably want to know when you can get the booster. Here's what experts can say. CDC Director Dr. Rochelle Walensky, Dr. Anthony Fauci, and the FDA's Dr. Janet Woodcock stated that the J&J booster shot may not come out anytime soon. This is because Pfizer and Moderna got a head start. Both mRNA vaccines were rolled out months before the J&J received an EUA. So it is logical that the first two will get a revised EUA early. Yet it depends on how fast J&J can give the much-needed data. The FDA wants to look into it first to determine how the vaccine will work as a two-dose. Why? Investigators have to make sure that the booster would be very effective and safe. To give you an idea about J&J's vaccine performance, the company shared on July 1 how it fared against the Delta variant. Based on the UNSOM study, the vaccine triggered neutralizing antibodies against Delta. J&J said that the vaccine was 85% effective in preventing severe or critical COVID. It also gave protection against hospitalization and death. Even at 85% effectiveness, you may still benefit from a booster shot. You can say the same to those who are vulnerable, like cancer and immunocompromised patients. We believe that the shot is worth it, especially when you are at the front line. Hopefully, this extra dose remains free. But what do you think of a J&J booster shot? Would you get it as well? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching!